Hi everyone, my name is Doug Bjerkaas and I'm on Team Dynamic Discs, PDGA number 14902, and I'm excited today to talk to you a little bit about what's in my bag, or as you can see here, what's actually in my cart. I've been a cart puller for a long time. I can remember having a cart that was made out of an old baby stroller, and someone made me a cart once, and I got to tell you, this Zuka cart that Dynamic Discs carries is awesome, and I love pulling my bag around as opposed to carrying it on my shoulders. So everything goes in the Dynamic Disc Zuka cart, and I have a Ranger bag inside that holds most of my discs. I have some of my putters on the backside here as well, but let's start talking right away about my drivers. I'm going to start with the discs I throw the least and then go to the ones I throw the most, and unfortunately that's my putter, which I throw way too many times. But anyhow, let's start with the drivers, and I throw three different molds as far as my drivers go. The first one that I throw is the Air Enforcer. And the Air Enforcer would be my most stable driver for an air disc. It's very light, and the older I get, the more I feel that the lighter the disc, the more confident I am with it in many cases. The Air Enforcer is a super stable disc. I can really, you know, torque on it, and it takes a lot to turn this thing over. I have to really try to turn it over to turn it over. From the Enforcer, I go to the Trespass, and the Trespass is probably the driver that I throw the most. I actually usually have between three and four of them in my bag at any time. One that I've recently started fooling around with is the Air Trespass, way different than my regular Trespasses, but this is a really cool disc if I want to throw a big Anheuser, really get something turning that's not going to come back. The Air Trespass is a really cool disc, and I've just started fooling around with that. You might notice on these two discs, I drew an E and a T because they're both air discs that are about the same color. I was playing a tournament in Denver about a month ago, and I pulled out what I thought was the Trespass, and it was the Enforcer, and bad things happened. So it's kind of important to know which disc you're throwing. As far as the Trespasses go, I have a Fusion Trespass, I have a Lucid Trespass that was dyed, and I have another Fusion Trespass, and they're all kind of in different stages. And you know, I'll be honest, beat-in discs versus new discs, I definitely can detect a little bit of a difference, but with my game, and maybe it's because of my arm speed, there's not a huge difference. And a lot of times, it really comes down to just, man, I think I want to throw the yellow one, or I think I want to throw the one that looks cool. Or I don't want to throw the one that looks cool because I don't want to throw it in the water. That's a bad thing to think about. But of the three Trespasses I throw, a lot of my decision-making about what I throw, it has to do with that moment in time, because to me, the Lucid isn't that much different from the Fusion, but sometimes I just prefer the feel of the Fusion as opposed to the Lucid. Basically, I can, you know, throw them as a hyzer. I can throw them on an Anheuser line. This Trespass is the one that I can most frequently throw a nice helix where it S's for me, and I can get a lot of distance with these. So those are my regular Trespasses. And then I also have two Sheriffs. I love the Sheriff. It's a little more fickle than my Trespass. If I'm going to flip a disc accidentally, it's more likely going to be the Sheriff, so I try to throw it in just ideal conditions. I have a Lucid and I have a Fusion. My Fusion has a Woody on it. That's kind of cool. One of my favorite Sheriffs. This Fusion is actually from the Line in the Pines tournament. Shout out to Marcus Rawls. This is the disc that I can probably throw the furthest of any disc in my bag, but I don't throw it near as often as I do the Trespass. So those are my drivers. On to my fairways. I have four different fairway molds that I have. One of the first dynamic discs I ever threw was an Escape. I love the Escape. The Escape is a great straight flyer with my arm speed. Some of the prettiest, straightest on a dot shots that I've ever thrown have been with the Escape. Can't throw it as far as a Trespass or a Sheriff, but it still gets some pretty good distance. That's typically the fairway driver I use. Now, if I need more meat, I throw the Felon, and I've got two Felons here. I've got one that's a fluid Felon, which to me is a little more stable than my Fusion Felon. The Fusion Felon I'll use if I want to get some skip. Again, this is super stable. It's gonna, if I throw it out to the right, it's gonna come back to the left. And again, I get much more skip with this Fusion than I do with the fluid one. I think the fluid one, maybe it's just mental, but I think it grips the ground a lot better. Super predictable. So I've got the Escape, the Felon, and the last fairway driver I have in my bag, which I only take out for extreme rare circumstances is my prime witness. And my prime witness is used for rollers. Shout out to Ron Converse. I was throwing a roller once in a tournament with him 3 or 4 years ago, and he said, "Hey, Doug, you should try the witness." So I did, and it has become my roller disc. I also will sometimes use this if I need a really big sky ante where I want to throw it way out to the left and have it definitely finish to the right. The witness is a great fairway driver. Okay, on to my mid-ranges. My mid-ranges, I love mid-ranges. They're some of my favorite discs in the world, and I love the fact that all of my mid-ranges basically feel the same in my hand, but they all do something a little bit different. The most stable mid-range that I throw, I know a lot of my teammates and friends throw the Justice, but for me, the Verdict is the most stable mid-range in my bag. I love the Verdict. If I had to play around with one disc, I'd probably go with my putter, but if I needed a disc other than my putter, I would definitely throw the Verdict. I just love the fact that I can throw it out straight. It's always going to finish a little bit left. I can stand on this disc. Again, much like the Air Enforcer, with my arm speed, I have a hard time turning this over unless I really intend to turn it over. I rarely accidentally turn over my Verdict. If I don't want something quite as stable as a Verdict, if I want it maybe to finish straighter, or if I do want to work the disc a little more, I throw the Truth. And I actually have three Truths in my bag. I have the most stable one is an EMAC Truth. And again, I bounce back and forth. Like if I lose a Lucid EMAC Truth, I might replace it with a Fusion EMAC Truth. To me, I know some people see a big difference in the plastics. To me, they just feel a little different, and I would throw either one. So the EMAC Truth is my most stable. My next stable one is a pre-Sweden Truth, a Lucid Truth. This disc I've had in my bag for a long time. I like the fact that the weight is one of those little ink spots, not actually in the mold. But that is my next stable one. And then my least stable one is an old Fusion Truth, a regular Truth with one of my favorite stamps on it. Go Vikings. And this disc, I really feel comfortable turning it over and really working it to the point where it also tends to come back. If I want to throw a disc that I'm going to turn over that's understable and it's a mid-range, I throw the Warrant. So the Warrant is kind of at the bottom of my mid-range list. I go Verdicts, then I go the EMAC Truth, then I go my regular Truths, and then the Warrant is my least stable. And I got to tell you, there's nothing more gratifying than taking and throwing the Warrant out flat and just seeing it turn right. It's an awesome, awesome disc, and I love the Warrant. That leads me to my putters, and you are gonna quickly find out that I am a Judge guy. I love the Judge, and I've got four different types of Judges in my bag. The first one is my Fusion Judge. This one actually has a baseball stamp on it. I have one with a butter stamp on it, my Butter Judge, that I need to get back in my bag. But the Fusion Judge, I love to just throw. Of all the discs in my bag that I feel like if I had to go play catch with somebody or if I had to hit certain targets, the Fusion Judge is money. And again, you know, I talked about how the Escape has produced a lot of really great looking straight dart shots. This Fusion Judge has also created some of those shots, and love the Fusion Judge as a driving putter. This is the putter that I most likely will drive with off of a tee if I'm going to use a putter. On the whole other end of that spectrum is a super soft classic Judge. And you can see I can fold that thing up like a paper football if I want to. It is super grippy. When I am trying to throw to a really slick green, maybe the basket's in a bunch of dirt, and if you guys have played on greens like that, you know the disc will just slip right through. This thing just, I feel so confident in the way that it grips the ground. I also like to throw this on big anhyzers with a putter. This thing flips over, and I'm really, really enjoy throwing this disc. I love this disc, but I'm not super comfortable actually putting with it. The third Judge that's in my bag is brand new, and it is a Prime Burst Judge. So new that all I've done is thrown it a couple times. I haven't even played around with it, but I've heard so many people talk about the Prime plastic, and I do have a Prime Witness that I use for a roller, but I've never used a Prime putter, and I just like the way it feels. So I'm kind of experimenting with this, maybe with some upshots. Maybe I'll get around the basket and putt a little bit with it as well. But that's a new Judge. It's the Prime plastic Judge that I'm starting to fool around with. And then the last two in my bag are the most important. These are my putters, and unfortunately and fortunately, they're the the disc I throw the most. One, because I usually have to throw it at least once on every hole. Unfortunately, sometimes it's three or four times a hole, and that's not good at all. But one of the things I've always done with putters is I get two of them, and I putt with a classic soft. Not the classic super soft, but a classic soft. And I always like to have two of them that are identical. And the reason for that is I sometimes can get, I don't want to say superstitious, but I'll go into the bag and I'll go, oh, I wonder which one's the hot one. And I always want two because I'm deathly afraid of losing a putter, which I've done. And that usually means that I get a new set of them. As soon as I lose a putter, I put the one that I didn't lose up on a shelf and I grab two more matching classic soft putters. And I just like to get behind these and putt. I'm more of a spin putter. And I just like the results with the judge. Ever since Dynamic Discs started making the judge, I've been putting with the judge. Couple other things that I'll just quickly mention. One thing that I think everyone should have in their bag is a PDGA rule book. I actually have two of them. This one's good until the end of 2017. This one will be good starting on in 2018. Always good to have a rule book. I keep a couple other things in here, some snacks, some sunscreen, some bug spray. This is one of the most valuable possessions in my disc golf bag. Folks that know me know that I've been carrying this around for probably 8-10 years, and when it gets really cold out, it's super simple to just put over my ears, and it's better than carrying around a big hat, and it's definitely seen better days. Finally, I've got, I might have mentioned that my putters I keep in a putter pouch. I do have a whale sack that I love. It has the Rocky Mountain Women's logo on it. Thank you, Tina, for making these. That's always cool to kind of get your hands dry. Love to carry water bottles with me. That's super important. And of course, I always have plenty of minis. I used to be real superstitious about my minis too, but now, you know, I've got a couple Trilogy Challenge minis, a Pink Judge mini, and hey, if Porter Yax is watching this, I have a, it's got Walter on it from the Big Lebowski. He runs a Big Lebowski double tournament down in Austin, and I've got a mini with Walter on it. So that is pretty much my bag/cart. Hope that was helpful and hope to see you guys on a course soon.